In this video, I want to show you what smart objects are and why you would want to work with smart objects in Photoshop. Now, here's my background layer. This is just the image I just opened in Photoshop. So I'm going to click the like icon to make this into a layer. So now I have a layer. And if I start transforming this, meaning if I reshape this, I'm just pressing Command T to get the transform tool. I'm holding Shift and I'm just going to make this small and I'll bring it right into the center of my image and I'll press OK. And if later I decided I want to make this back to full screen to fill my canvas, I could just go ahead and fill the screen with this. And if I press OK, look at the image quality. I lost a lot of image quality here. This image used to be really sharp. Let me just go ahead and step back. I'll just step back a couple of times just to show you. See, it was much sharper than the image we ended up with because when we free transformed, Photoshop basically threw away some of that information. So in order to save that information, we need to change this to a smart object. So with this layer selected, we want to go to layer, smart object, and convert to smart object. And now that's a smart object, we could basically reshape this any way we want to. And if we press OK and then resize it back to normal, we don't lose any quality. Now this makes your Photoshop file bigger, but it gives you the opportunity to really reshape things every which way that you want to and not lose any information. Now, the one thing is, let me pick the brush tool here. I can't use the brush tool here because it's a smart object. And it says, do you want to rasterize the smart object? You could press OK and do that. But we don't want to do that in this case because we lose the smart object. So I'm going to step back. So what we want to do in order to use the brush tool or the clone tool or the dodge tool, any of the tools that we often use in an image, is by having this selected, we'll go to layer, we'll go to smart object, and we'll go edit content. This will let us edit the content, meaning it opens that in its own individual layer. So now we could use the brush tool within that layer. And now if we close it and press save, in the original image, we did not lose our smart object. So now we could still go ahead and free transform without losing any information in that image like we did when we weren't using it as a smart object. So that's why smart objects are important, and I recommend using smart objects in your Photoshop, especially when you're working with images and multiple layers. I hope you found this useful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for a lot more videos like this one. And if you like my teaching style and you want to see a lot more Photoshop tutorials, please let me know in the comment and let me know what you want to see, and I'll try to make it on our next set of videos. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.